Hi nerds, hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. This week we are doing another bombshell blast, this one inspired by Batgirl. So you always see her in the pictures and figures and everything with her cape open, she's always flinging her cape open. So our version of that is going to be Down Dog Kicks of Fire, which are very exciting. So we'll start in our mountain pose though, just to warm up, get the breath going, let the body know that we're going to be start doing some more intense movement. So we'll inhale here, grounding the feet into the earth. Inhale as you wave your spine up tall, arms unfurl to the sky, and exhale, fold yourself down, keeping the knees bent, just a gentle forward fold here. Inhale here, prepare as you bend the knees, getting closer to the earth, and exhale, waving yourself in and up. Inhale, fills the pose at the top. Exhale, forward fold. Again, just starting with bent knees. Don't need to worry about straightening our knees right away. Inhale in here, prepare as you bend to get really close to the earth. Exhale, using that momentum to lift yourself in and up, rolling and unfurling to the sky as you inhale. Exhale, forward fold. This time we'll hold this forward fold. Again, just finding that first edge of stretch. Wave yourself back and forth. You can bend one knee more than the other, straighten the other knee a little bit more, and just opening the legs. And exhale, sitting or bending the knees, getting real close to the earth. And one last time, rolling yourself in and up. Coming into mountain, hands come to heart center. In Namaste or Anjali Mudra, we will make our way now to a downward dog. And from here, insert in your hands and knees and really ground your fingertips into the earth. Make sure you have good alignment with the hands. That's obviously, we're going to be putting a lot of pressure and weight on those, so we want to ground into the earth with our fingertips, ring of the palms, very lightweight on the heel of the palm, and in down dog, pedal out the feet. Letting the legs know that we are going to get moving here. Awesome. Now for our kicks of fire, you can do it all the whole thing on your knees or the whole thing in down dog. I'll probably do half and half so that you can see, but you want to have really good grounding in the earth, and we're going to keep our elbows buoyant. We're not going to wing them out. Keep them close to the center. And we'll be kicking, just kicking up, really kicking out through the heel. Obviously both sides. You don't necessarily have to think about kicking up, it's kicking out, using our derriere. And same thing when you're in down dog, that you might get a little more up movement when doing those kicks. Now with the Tabata timing, you know we're 20 seconds on, and then rest, and then we'll switch legs. I like to try and count how many reps I've done on one leg and, you know, even it out on the other. So find a pace that's good for you. Like I said, you can do it all on your knees, all in down dog. You can mix it up, go back and forth, whatever is easiest for you. You want it to be challenging and, of course, fun. So we'll come into our Tabata timing and get prepped. And really focus on kicking out. And you'll notice I'm breathing with each rep. I want to make sure that you're getting lots of oxygen. Now when you rest, you can come to sit on your heels, on your feet, grounded to the earth, and switch sides. Again, you can try and match the reps if you want, or just go all out and see how many you get. You'll also notice I'm having a little bend in my arms each each time that I'm kicking. You don't want to do this super still in your arms. It's not great for the joints. You want that momentum to help you with each pose. But also you'll get a bit of arm workout. You can always do smaller bends too, smaller kicks if you want. Maybe a little more cardio. And if you want, just, you know, you don't necessarily have to breathe with each kick either. You can just take longer breaths, maybe 3 kicks per breath. Again, whatever is going to work best for you. I'm just kind of showing you a bunch of different varieties, walking you through different ways you can do this exercise. Since it is your yoga practice, we want you to enjoy it. Awesome. And when you're resting, you can massage out your forearms, wrists, obviously putting a lot of pressure on those. And then you can always do your kicks in down dog. Shake out your wrists, make sure you're breathing, and in that 10-second rest, you can even do some lion's breath. Get out any old air before trying to breathe in new air. You'll notice too, when I'm in actual down dog doing this, getting a little bend on the bottom leg, using that momentum as well. Shake it out, some lion's breath, stretch it out, ground it to the earth. Awesome, a few more seconds here. All right, massage out your wrists again. And back in it. These kicks of fire are no joke. Probably feeling pretty fiery right now. You are done. Make your way back into a seated position. Some cat-cow. Add some lion's breath. Want to slow the heart rate down. We really got it working with that one. And interlace your fingers behind you. Open up the chest. Counterpose to all of that pressing into and away from the earth that we just did. Then, of course, massage out your forearms. Pull the wrists away from the forearm, get some traction. It's going to feel really good after putting pressure on our wrists. Awesome. Now from here, we're going to make our way back to down dog. But don't worry, we're cooling down now. So bending everything close to the earth. Inhale, lift the right leg high. To start, we're going to open the hip and just let our left or our right foot fall behind us. And then we are going to exhale, bringing our right knee to chest, coming through core plank. Right foot plants on the earth. Inhale, start waving long spine. and exhale, straightening the front foot. Inhale, coming back into a lunge. Exhale. Inhale as you do the lunge, getting into the hip flexor a bit. Exhale. Last time here, inhale. And exhale. Waving the spine long over that front leg. And from here, take your left hand, plant it in the earth underneath, on the earth, rather underneath your shoulder. And right arm twists to the sky. Getting the side of our leg here as well. Your forward fold, bend the right leg, step back to your down dog. Inhale here, everything close to the earth. Left leg lifts this time, opening the hips and dropping the left foot behind you. Getting into our psoas when we do this one. And coming through your core plank, left foot steps forward to left thumb. Inhale here, prepare a long spine. And then exhale as you bring the front leg straighter and fold. Inhale, back to your lunge, getting the hip flexor. Exhale as you fold. Inhale. Exhale. And one last time, coming into your lunge, stretching the hip flexor for a moment, and exhale, coming to your forward fold. Inhale here, wave the spine long as you fold over that leg, coming to your first edge of stretch here. And now planting the right hand underneath the shoulder, and the left arm reaches up to the sky, and the back heel, you can have it coming naturally towards the earth or lifting it up if you prefer. Just find a stretch that feels better for you today. Could even be different on each side, who knows? And here, coming back to your forward fold, bending the left leg, stepping back to down dog. We'll do a vinyasa to move all of that energy along our whole body, so bending everything close to the earth, waving yourself forward to plank, planting your knees, lowering through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, rolling in and up. And exhale, make your way to down dog. Step your feet forward to meet your hands and make your way to a comfortable seated position. Before we go into our final resting pose, we'll stretch out the arms. They did get some work today, stretching it across and stretching it behind us, getting into our triceps, and switch. And feel free, of course, to hold any of these stretches for longer if need be. You can always hit pause. It's one of the great things about doing a video and practicing at home. Awesome. And take yogi's choice moment, any other stretches you feel you might need before making your way down into Shavasana, final resting pose. When you do get here, just take up as much space on the floor as you can. Get comfortable, really letting this practice sink into your body and form new alignment for you. I do hope that you enjoyed that practice. I had a lot of fun with it, so I look forward to seeing you on the mat for the next one. It should also be a lot of fun. Make sure that you are subscribed to the YouTube channel. You'll get notifications when the new videos are up, and got the League of Nerdy Yogis email list for you if you want to get some exclusive content. Namaste.